Hello, Soldier Boy here, and welcome back to Flyweight Career on UFC 4. So you join us in our 4-fight winning streak. We're 4-0, and we're about to face our next opponent. So it's Rhys Clark, 17-1. 5-week camp. I was messing around with the camps. I'm going to take it down 4. I think I can get everything I need done in 4. I probably should maximise it. He's a 1.5 star. And he's a kickboxer. So, for us, again, it's going to be take the fight to the ground. Hopefully, he should be weak there as a kickboxer. And we're going to utilise our ground game where possible. If you are enjoying these videos, don't forget to like, subscribe. Ring the bell just so you're notified of when these episodes are out every Thursday night. Let's see the tail of the tape.
Well, this is truly an 8-point striker, DC, a Muay Thai practitioner making the walk to the
octagon. So Rhys Clark, Hounslow, England. Okay, another English fighter. Well balanced, won 11 fights in a row. He's won 11 out of 12. So he lost his debut and then went on 11 fight winning streak. Okay, so he's definitely not someone to be sniffed at, admittedly. Not a fan of his tattoo, I'll give you that. Hopefully, if we stick to a game plan, we should have a good chance of getting something out of this. I am enjoying career. I've seen a few other people do videos and stop pretty quickly, complaining about the different lack of variety in career mode. Yeah, I agree. It's not as good as what they said. The amount of things they said was being added. But you've got to challenge yourself. You've got to make it a personal challenge as well. So here we are. Brian Walker.
It's something he's going to have to bottle here tonight. These lights are bright. He doesn't look wide-eyed making the walk here, but there might be an adrenaline dump if you do too much.
Dangerous submission game. Won 4 fights in a row and 4 out of the last 4 fights. This is our UFC debut as well. I should have made more of a big deal of that, to be fair. But yeah, this is a UFC debut after our Contender Series win. Got us the contract. So here we go. 29-23, 163, same reach. So that's good for us. The problem if he's got a long reach, it makes it harder for us to get close to him, but luckily he hasn't. Let's hand over to Bruce Buffer.
Fighting out of the blue corner, a Muay Thai fighter holding a professional record of 17 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds, Iceman! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, making his UFC debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds, fighting out of Liverpool, England, Walker!
All right, what can we do? UFC debut.
And when the action begins, our referee
kind of underplayed it. I should have made a big deal out of the debut. Yeah, my fault. But let's make this work. All right, what can we do? Let's go. Coming out with the jabs just to try and keep him honest. We are going to look to get this to the floor, but to start with, we've got to try and take some of that stamina down. Nice clinch. We managed to get out of it. We've got a little shot in there. A bit dirty boxing. Just trying to drain the stamina with the body kicks. We did check the leg there. That head kick he didn't know. Lovely head kick. Back into the clinch. Oh, another lovely head kick. He's not putting as much offense out as I thought he would. For a kickboxer, there we go. I say it and he kicks us. Alright, this is what we've got to defend though. Back into the clinch. Nice uppercuts. Couple landed there. Oh, both kind of kicked together. Oh, went for the takedown. His leg got in the way. Missing the takedown so far. His leg kicks are hurting. There we go. Double leg. Straight down. We've now got him down. Just trying to increase my position. That's why I got up. And, yeah. With four fights in to a to a career, plus the tutorial fight, and then decides to give us a ground and pound tutorial. Don't understand that, but there we go. Trying to just advance position, he is stopping us fairly well. Some good punches, we just can't seem to do too much with him though, that's the only problem. Good pressure, it's just not doing as much as I want. But it's a difference. If your feet are on a hip, it's a problem. And he's kicked us away and he's back up on his feet. Yeah, he should have done more with that position. I just couldn't get it to work for us. But another double leg. Down he goes again. Standing back up again. I'm just trying to get the position right. Side control, perfect. Look at the. We've gone for the arm. I don't know if it's probably too early for the Kimura, to be fair. Still got good stamina, that's the problem. No, I think he's going to escape. I don't think it's going to be tight enough. I think he's got too much stamina. We are trying though. No, and he's turned us over, so he's now got the dominant position. We've now got to try and do something from the ground. We're going for the submission from below. Again, I don't think we've got a chance. His stamina's too high at this point. But if you're going to get on top of me, I am going to try and submit from the bottom game. That's always my move. I have no issue going for a submission from underneath.
Alright, so there's the end of the round. A lot of high level action. And if you like the takedown game, as my boy Daniel Cormier does, you enjoyed that.
It's definitely scoring us points. Takedowns and going for submissions will always score you points. That's what we need. We know his ground game isn't brilliant. We need to capitalise on that if we're going to keep this win streak going. Got to win the debut. Can't let it go decision. We've got to win it outright, I think. Got to set the tone straight away. Nice punches. Our aim is getting back to the ground. We are dominant on the ground. Oh, nice head kick. Definitely hurt him. Back into the clinch. Couple of uppercuts land nicely. Keeping him backed against the cage. Gone for the single. We have brought him down. We're on top. Getting back up again. I am going to look to change my controls. I think some of the issue I'm having with positioning is the ground game controls. I'll probably go for the hybrid. I think that will be a bit better for me. Double leg straight down. Back on top. And again, didn't mean to do that. It's a case of pressing the wrong button. I'm going to have to change the controls, I think, for the ground. Looking for the arm triangle. Got it locked in. I don't know if this will be good enough this time. Can we get it tight? Still got high stamina, that's the problem. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be enough. This might just be a matter of time. No, he's going to escape. We've still got top position though, that's something. We're going to go for another triangle now.
try to get a triangle choke here.
This might be a little bit closer the way this is looking. Got a chance. We have a good chance. Can we get this locked in? UFC debut win. Come on. I think we've got it. I think we've got it. And we have. We win a UFC debut. Look at that. Lovely submission. It's definitely working. Using the character as a submission-based fighter is definitely working. They are obviously lower level opponents. I wonder how far we can go with this. Once we come up against better wrestlers, I think it'll be a little bit harder with better submission defenses.
He never rushes. He takes his time, but it's his trickiness.
But a lovely finish.
His ability to trick people into going to the floor with him that puts them in danger and finishing fights.
Cameraman got a fantastic view there. Straight up the top
so
of us.
So there is your winner by submission tonight, and that is how you put the rest of the division on notice. A huge result for
official result from Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3:44 of round number 2. Declaring the winner by tap out due to arm triangle choke.
Well, what an incredible result here tonight as you see the winners.
Fantastic win for us. We'll take it. They put so much stuff medium height, managed to hype it up a decent amount.
Really spin his career forward. They needed to not just win but get the finish, and they certainly got it tonight.
They got the finish. He's such a terrific grappler. Every time he is on,
should have really picked up the UFC debut a little bit more. But we got the win. That's the main thing. We can now move on with our career and keep the wins coming, hopefully. The only problem I have with these views, when people record your finish, is you can't see anything. Okay, it seems a bit pointless. Now, if you can see what was actually happening there, you've got better eyesight than me. So a decent win. Good start to UFC career. I kind of wish I'd stayed in WFA a little bit longer and won a belt there, really. I might have to look at that next time. Wait to start in the UFC once we finish with the flyweight division. Dana White. Good. Five winning streak. That's what we want. Keep that streak going. A few tweets. Need to get a rival as well. That's why I've always been detrimental to any tweets that I could reply to. I want a rival. Well, I won that rival fight. I think that definitely up the amount of supporters we'd get from that kind of fight. You don't get many chances to actually reply, though. That's the problem. Right, let's have a look at the fight. What's next? Second UFC fight. Andrew Marshall. 15-5. Okay, 4-week camp. We'll keep it at 4 weeks. 1.5-star overall. He's a kickboxer. So, another kickboxer. There seems to be a lot of those around. I think it'll be the same game plan as last time. It's going to be take him to the floor, submission. Most kickboxers are good on their feet, not so much on the floor. That's the difference. And that's always my game plan. I will have to change my game plan when we come up against wrestlers. But, trying to create my fire as a submission fire, got to go for the submissions. All right, this is our opponent coming out now. New Zealand, Andrew Mark. Oh no, sorry, not New Zealand. I hold my hands up, Australia. Definitely got that flag wrong. Andrew Marshall. Well balanced, won 4 fights in a row, has lost 5 fights in his career. So, to be fair, the pedigree of a previous fight was probably more than he is, which is a bit weird. He'd only lost one, he's lost 5. But he's on a 4-fight winning streak. We're on a 5-fight winning streak. So, we've got to add another loss to his resume, really. Let's see what they say about us. Dominant and most aggressive forms of striking
in the UFC. Well, it's always exciting when you have such a high-level Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner. This man has been a master of the submission in the UFC, and even though a lot of people know what's coming,
loving that master of submission.
Because the knowledge of the jiu-jitsu game is
dangerous submission game. Won 5 out of his last 5 fights, won 5 fights in a row. Cool. So they're making note of my submission game. That's the main thing. I need him to be known as a submission fighter. And as you slam him to the ground, he starts to understand, okay, I'm right where I need you right now. This is when the game starts for him. If he doesn't secure that submission, he gets you where he needs you to be in order to start to really make you drown. It's like going in deep water and getting pulled down over and over again, because every time you think, if I do this, so
it'll make it better.
We have a massive reach advantage, 8 centimeters. Wow. I wasn't expecting a reach advantage to be that big.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC Flyweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a Muay Thai fighter holding a professional record of 16 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of Sydney, Australia, Cyclops. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 5 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of Liverpool, England.
There we go.
Walker. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
All right, another win needed. I may have to change that. I'm really not a fan of that entrance at all. I'm definitely not a fan of that one though either. Alright. Come on then. Let's get him on. Definitely more offense than the first guy did in the start. Now an even higher ranked opponent stares in front of him. The octagon door is closed. We'll see if he can. Nice in the clinch. A few uppercuts land nicely. Overhand right. Dirty boxing now. We've got to defend. He's really going out with the knees. He is dangerous. Oh, he's gone for a takedown. Single leg. He gets us on the floor. We're looking for a submission from below. I don't think we're going to get this locked in tight, but it's definitely giving him a cause for concern. I can't believe a kickboxer didn't take that. I know they do. I just wasn't expecting it in any shape, way or form. We might actually pull this off, you know. We might actually pull this off. This might be an early first round finish. We might do it. We have done it. I was not expecting that quickly. That was amazing. He took us down. And we got the triangle from below.
And you didn't even have to pay for your seat.
Wow.
He's done. What a fight.
Well, yeah, so the work in the gym pays off.
I was not expecting it to be that quick. Here we go. Look, we went for the leg kick. He took the single leg. Got us on the floor. And yeah, triangle locked in. Full stamina he would have had as well. His submission defense must have been atrocious. Must have done it that quickly. I was not expecting that. I thought it'd be like this last one. Do a couple of submissions, he'll get out of them. Take to the second round.
He is the best grappler, best submission specialist we've seen in a long time.
I'm happy with that. Very, very happy. Now I understand why he's lost a lot of 5 previous fights, to be fair. At least it keeps our longevity going, because we're getting them done quickly, we're not getting hurt. That's the main thing. Wow. I was not expecting that. But we'll take it. Every day of the week. Let's just keep them coming like that. That's the main thing for us. Again, not a fan. You can't see what's happening. I just think they're pointless, them little bits. I know it's to help the loading screens and keep something going while it's loading. It just annoys me now. That's a better angle. That is a lot better angle. There's no point being up in the bleachers and showing that. That's pointless. But that was definitely a lot better angle. Well, UFC debut and second fight in UFC, and two wins in the win column. 6-0. What a way to go. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, like, subscribe. Always leave me a comment, let me know what you think. UFC Korea is out every Thursday night. My UFC Online is Tuesday night. I'm looking to do some Blitz at some point as well and try and add that in as well, just to break it up a little bit. But yeah, hopefully you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.